Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to show you some of the features we can use to time synchronize Fusion 2 during INS operations. We're also going to look at how to use Fusion 2 as a time source for an external system. This could be for something like dynamic laser mapping, where we want to minimize latency and enable the best fit between our laser and navigation data. So firstly, we'll look at the time sync input setup. Before we configure the software, we need to physically connect the 1PPS and ZDA to the system. The ZDA can be connected to the topside system or directly to the sprint unit, depending on what you have available. Even if the system has a navigation sensor hub, the 1PPS signal from the GNSS must be connected directly to the sprint E1 or C1 ports. Once we have that, we can configure the software. In the bottom left corner, we have the toolbox, and on the top of that, we have the setup cogs. With that open, you can see I have my ROV configured with the necessary aiding sensors. To add the ZDA, we can right-click on the tree or click Add. Run through the drop-down menu here to find time, and then the ZDA input. Set the port the ZDA is on, in my case COM49, and click Apply. Now, if we look at the system setup, we can see that the software has moved the device from the ROV to the system part of the tree. If we click on that and select the data tab, we can check that the ZDA is being decoded properly. Now, if we go to the sprint instrument, we have a time sync tab. This is only available once we've added the ZDA instrument. In here, we can configure the 1PPS. Under source, we can choose ZDA only or ZDA with 1PPS, so we'll select that. Then we need to set the port we've connected the PPS to, that's E1 for me. And then we set up when the 1PPS is valid, rising, falling, etc. If you're not sure, then at the very least make sure all the systems using that time source are set the same. Once we click Apply, we can now see that the LED is flashing, and if we go back to the system setup page, we can see everything is green. If we have a problem, we should see an alarm, otherwise you're good to go. Next, we'll look at how to use Fusion 2 as the time source for another system. The first thing to do is to update the clock on the sprint itself. So we'll go back into the time sync tab and set the source to none to allow it to free run. We can now click on set now to update the time in sprint. Then we'll go back to the system setup page and right click to create an output. Set the port you want the ZDA to go out on, COM150 for me. Then go to the outputs properties and set the source to sprint. Set the type to 1PPS plus ZDA. Finally, configure which sprint port you were using for the 1PPS, which is usually T1 on the sprint itself. You should now see both ZDA and 1PPS outputting. So that's that, you're ready to go. If you have any questions, please contact the survey support group using support@sonardyne.com. For more detailed information on this or on any of our other Sonardyne products, please check out the training pages on our website. Happy tracking and goodbye!